Cougars Heating Roofing Friday Night Rivals, driven by Cruz Chevrolet.
To the backyard, we welcome you for Keating Roofing Friday Night Rivals, driven by Cruz Chevrolet, a 1-0 physical Colleton County team, and a James Island program led by Jamar McCoy trying to pick up its first win of the season. Alongside Dean Stevens, the main anchor at ABC News 4, I'm Darren Goldwater, and when you look at this one, Dean, first and foremost, we will start with the Cougars here, because what we know about them is they are big, they're physical, and they like to pound the rock.
And the thing you love to see about this Colleton County program is they are off to a good start. And this is a program, actually both of these programs, with storied past. They've had a lot of success through the 90s and the 2000s, but they have run across tough times. Jamar McCoy brought in to turn this James Island program around, and Kobe Peeler seems to have done that early on here at his start at Colleton County.
Peeler wants to play a physical brand of football, and he wants to run it a lot. Nayron Holmes runs the show, and he combined for 280 yards and four scores last week.
Well, you see this young man, and he's got a great line up front. And his lines from last week, not bad. 160 yards through the air with two touchdowns. He also rushed for 121 with two touchdowns as well. As you can see, Colleton County will certainly go by the way of Nayron Holmes.
For James Island, we could see two, maybe even three quarterbacks, but right there, Jaden Scott, that's who they're all going to be looking to. He leads the receiving core and as a defensive back, but he's got over 100 yards receiving so far.
First two games been tough for James Island, but Jaden Scott has caught 14 passes. This against a defense, the Colleton County defense, that gave up just a few yards through the air, under 100. It's going to be a tough go for Jaden Scott and his team tonight.
Is this the night Jamar McCoy picks up his first victory as the head coach of the Trojans? Or will it be the Cougars moving to 2-0 and in the thick of the playoff race in Region 7-4A? It's the Keating Roofing Friday Night Rivals, driven by Cruz Chevrolet. Game of the week, and it's right after this. to the backyard where Colleton County is getting set to return the opening kickoff here. Your Keating Roofing Friday Night Rivals driven by Cruz Chevrolet. Your game time temperature brought to you by Roper St. Francis is a balmy 75 degrees. It was actually a little bit nicer earlier. And then rain came through and it got more humid. And if it's humid, then you know the backyard, it's even more humid. James Island's going to kick off to a Colleton County team that played its first game a couple of weeks ago, did not play last week. They're 1-0. And they ran 53 plays 2 weeks ago, and all but nine of them were on the ground. That's Anton Griffin. He's set to return for the Cougars, who are led by Kobe Peeler. Peeler has done a nice job turning around this Colleton County program, and this is one of those games where he told me earlier today they got to just play physical, cut down on the mistakes. The mistakes he saw in their opening game were fixable mistakes. And we're underway with the boot from Hugo Taylor. What a name. Hugo Taylor blows one out of the end zone. And here's your starting offense. Nayron Holmes is going to lead the show. Jordan Simmons is the top receiver. When you look down towards the bottom of the starters, brought to you by Keating Roofing, you see HB.
Yeah.
Doesn't necessarily stand for halfback. He's going to be more of a fullback style. Mm-hmm. Jackie White will tote the rock.
Mm-hmm. When I saw number 74 as a HBFB, I got so excited. 6'1", 270. Oh.
Yeah.
Wouldn't that be nice? Going to be fun.
Kobe Ferguson moves to the left side of the line, and it will be Jackie White through the middle for maybe about 5 yards. And that's how we get underway here for the Cougars.
Hunter Higgins on the tackle. We're going to call his name a lot tonight.
This doesn't look good for Jackie White. He's up limping around already. The defense is led by Hunter Higgins, as Dean just said, and 35 as you look down towards the very bottom of the starters there. Jaquan Wallace, 17 tackles in a couple of games with an interception as well. Just a junior, but he leads that defense, according to Jamar McCoy. So Jackie White, with one carry, comes up hobbling here a little bit. And what Kobe Peeler said to me, we'll get to that here. First, the Cruz Chevrolet keys to the game, Sir Stevens.
Thank you, sir, for Colleton County. You said it. They're just going to wear them out on the front line. Their front line is big for James Island. It is the QB shuffle. They're going to have to figure out and get some consistency at that spot.
Holmes slips one tackle, gets back to the line of scrimmage, and is tackled there. 19 is a defensive end, John Grant. And it brings up third down and about 5 yards to go for the Cougars. And that injury to Jackie White, and we'll keep an eye on that. What Kobe Peeler said to me today, he said, you know, we've got some talent. The problem is we have no depth right now. He said, as long as we can stay healthy, things are going to be okay, but we just don't have the depth. He had a lot of kids who decided not to play this year. Third and five, that's 5 yards back over Holmes' head, and he still kicks it around. He kicks it right to Higgins, a touchdown for the Trojans.
Did I say you're going to hear a lot about Hunter Higgins tonight?
Nostradamus called it, and the Trojans have a 6-0 lead.
You talked about eliminating the mistakes. A bad snap is going to happen. The mental mistake on that is that ball just need to be, he just needed to fall on that ball. Simple, Holmes. He could have just downed it about the 5-yard line, but they give an easy score over to James Island and Hunter Higgins.
And Hugo Taylor gets to come back out with Elliot Dupree holding. Picks up a low snap, and it's 7-0 Trojans. A minute and 13 seconds into this thing. Fumble return for a score by Hunter Higgins. And the Trojans have a lead. They are 0-2 on the year. And have gotten blown out twice. So this couldn't possibly have been a better start here for the Trojans.
Well, in their first two games, they scored 7 against May River and 6 against Buford. So the defense is doing their part early on.
Election Day is Tuesday, November 3rd. So go vote! Sponsored by Jamie Harrison for Senate.
The door to the American dream opens through education. Jamie Harrison is running to open those doors for all South Carolinians.
All right.
Senior Hugo Taylor. I hope they score a lot so we can say Hugo a bunch.
Well,
it may bring back bad memories for some.
You listen to the announcer there at James Island. He loves saying the name Hugo.
First one went out of the end zone.
Listen to him.
It's an automatic touchback in high school when it gets into the end zone. Good little leg right there for Taylor. Speaking of names.
Yes.
We've got the Florida Gators at Texas A&M tomorrow. And one of the stars of this young college football season is Florida's tight end, Kyle Pitts.
Yes.
You know where he got the name Kyle?
From Kyle Field.
That's right. His parents grew up Aggies fans.
I did see that.
And now he's going to play at Kyle Field.
I did see that. It's one of the better environments in college football. I've been there a couple of times. It pains me to say it, but it's true. They got an amazing tradition at A&M. It's a cool place.
So Jackie White not back out there. Nayron Holmes, man, does he take a shot as he gets to the third level. Hunter Higgins, who returned the first fumble for a touchdown, is the one who laid into him after a first down carry.
Yeah, one problem with James Island's defense, and they've given up some points early on, is that they're leading tacklers. It's a big hit by 35. That's Jaquan Wallace. He's leading the team in tackles with 17. Noah Brown is second.
Trey Magwood getting the carries in place of White. Tag team stop there. 16, Kiroy Ankrum, one of the linebackers, leads the way.
And defensively, you don't want your safeties to be your leading tacklers on your team.
No, that tells you that a lot of guys are getting through to the third level.
Yep. You see that set, see the big guys up front.
And Holmes is smothered. One of the safeties, Noah Brown, held his ground on the outside right there, number 10, his 10th tackle of the year.
It's a really interesting setup, bringing some of your big uglies in the backfield. I mean, their offensive line, 280, 260, 260, 285, 290 as it is. And then you bring Sagron Bowman, 6'2", 270. He's number 74.
Jackie White back in. Holmes, look at him rear back to throw that thing. And it's nearly intercepted as DJ Dickerson has the positioning.
You know, you sit on your couch on a Friday or a Saturday or a Sunday and you watch defensive backs never turn their head, and I don't understand why. I was a guard. Anyway, but what a great job he does right at the last minute. That's what you want to see. You're kind of playing off the eyes of the receiver. And then you make your move as a defensive back, and what a nice job by DJ Dickerson.
A fumble that leads to a touchdown on their opening drive, then quickly giving it right back to the Trojans here. That punt is going to go about 12 yards, so the Trojans will have excellent field position for their first offensive series.
Two bad snaps for Colleton County in their first two possessions.
And that allows the Trojans to start from their 46-yard line. The starting quarterback has been changed. You see Braxton Scott there. We do expect to see Braxton Scott. He's a freshman who played three quarters last week and really has put up some decent numbers. But instead, it will be number 11, Aiden Cernigliero. That's at least what we thought. Instead, it is Aiden Cernigliero. I had him listed incorrectly with the wrong number, but he is number 9, and he hands it off anyway for a decent gain on first down. Big lineup defensively as well. The linebackers of Daryl Green and Lamontre Green, unrelated, 31 and 33. Those are the leaders of the defense. And the cornerback, Jaheim Bellamy, as well. We may see that Bellamy and Jaden Scott matchup just a few times tonight.
Bellamy with a couple of interceptions already in the year.
There's a penalty on the back end of that. So a first down for the Trojans here.
So for a team that needed to get going in a positive way, James Island here with an opportunity to put another 7 on the board.
And Colleton County is giving them opportunities. You got the bad snaps that have resulted in a bad punt and a fumble recovery for a touchdown, a penalty that gives you a first down, and a subsequent penalty that makes it 1st and 5.
And not the start Coach Peeler wants to see from his Colleton County crew.
No.
Who really had their way last week against Bluffton, a 28-7 win.
Amontre Scott, another freshman. The Trojans will play a few of them as Jamar McCoy tries to change the culture here. He was able to do it at his alma mater. He came from Hunter Huss High School in Gastonia, North Carolina. That was his alma mater. Coached there for 6 years, and the last 4 of them were outstanding seasons. He said it felt the same when he got to James Island, that same family feel, accepted like he was one of their own. And they'll stay on the ground. This time it's Terrio McKelvey, and it's a first down for the Trojans. It's a West Shore home first down. You can convert your old bathtub into a modern and spacious walk-in shower in 1 day. While you watch football all day tomorrow, your bath can just be a shower. WestShoreHome.com.
Offensive line doing a nice job on those first 2 runs.
Helping them get into the Miller-Mott College Red Zone. You can take control of your future with the skills to succeed at Miller-Mott College. No urgency for the Trojans.
Mm-mm, none at all. I think one of their focus here is to make sure those chains stay short, don't get a negative play here. Turn the punt into some positive points.
The longer they use up the clock, more beneficial it is to him. Underneath, it goes to Dupree, who stretches to the 2-yard line, and they're knocking on the door again. Chris Hires with the touchdown saving stop.
Just a quick strike. Got a good release. Keeps it nice and low. Elliott does a nice job grabbing it and picking up some extra yards.
Third grab of the year for Dupree. Second completion of the year for Sir Nigliero. Waiting for that hole. That's McKelvey, who maybe gets back to the line of scrimmage there as Bynum rides him down.
He's waiting for, I believe that was big number 77, Carter Kreitz, to pave the way. But again, as you said, they're going to take their time here, work the clock a little bit. I know it's early to say it.
Shorten the game. Here's McKelvey. He's wrapped up immediately. Grabbed by the big arms of Landon Garvin, and it's 3rd and goal.
It's 5'11", 265, Landon Garvin. We'll call him Mr. Garvin from here on out. But he finds the gap. Does a nice job for the loss.
Man, the Trojans will take a timeout to talk about this one. Knocking on the door, a goal-to-go situation. It is 3rd and goal now with a chance to go up by 2 scores in the opening quarter. Keating Roofing Friday Night Rivals driven by Cruz Chevrolet, and the winless Trojans have a shot to go up early. A Mass Cam brought to you by DHEC, fight the spread of COVID-19 as we get you back to the backyard here. Trojans threatening to go up by 2 scores. The next points the Trojans score will be their most points in a game this season. And they'll load up the backfield with Tykel Maxwell, a linebacker at number 10. One of two ahead of McKelvey.
Just a numbers game right here. Get him to the outside.
And the Cougars came with the numbers and bounced him out of bounds, shy of that pylon. It'll be fourth and goal.
And a lucky break for the Trojans. And McKelvey, he lost the ball as he was being brought down. The ball goes out of bounds before the pylon. If it goes out of bounds in the end zone, it's a turnover.
Let's see where.
I think what he was doing, he was trying to reach his arm out for that pylon. And they're going to go for it.
Amontre Scott, one of two in front of McKelvey. Here he is again, backing his way down. That works. The fourth time's a charm for the Trojans, who lead it 13-0 halfway through the opening period.
Love it. I love the new coach putting faith in his offense. Doesn't care about the numbers, who's bigger than who. But a poor punt and a couple of penalties by Colleton County. Nice job.
McElvey makes it 13-0 as Hugo Taylor tacks on the extra point. Kobe Peeler said to limit the mistakes. They were correctable mistakes from their previous game, but mistakes have helped James Island to this 2-score lead. Keating Roofing proud to present each participating home school a check for $500. The grant provides each school with extra funding to help make their school great. Over the past 10 seasons, Friday Night Rivals and our sponsors have donated over $100,000 to Lowcountry students and schools. We congratulate you from ITV Charleston, ABC News 4, and Keating Roofing. That is the look of a displeased head coach of the Cougars there, Kobe Taylor.
You take a look at these two programs, similar in how they got to this place. They, again, in the 90s, in the 2000s, Colleton County being Walterboro, James Island, they both found a lot of success. But as the success kind of fell by the wayside, so did the numbers, the kids coming out.
Mm-hmm.
And when you rebuild a program like Coach Peeler's doing the last few years at Colleton County, and he's found success this year already.
First kickoff that is actually returnable from the 3-yard line and close to the 30. Goes Penseel. I'll give him about 24 yards on the return. He's stopped there by Donaldson. And we crunch the numbers for the first time, presented by Anderson Brothers Bank.
You talk about a decade to forget. Last 10 years, Colleton County 36-71. James Island with 27-90-1. The only two winning seasons out of Colleton County, James Island. James Island had two of them. But as they start to find success, that's when the kids start coming from the hallways out onto the football fields.
Yeah, winning is fun. You start to see winning and want to be a part of winning. Here's White, gang tackled back there. Lawson Paredes leads the way, and it's a loss of about 5.
Desmond Lewis also there.
I appreciate the boisterous and booming voice of the public address announcer, and I am being completely serious, because sometimes when you don't have the opportunity to get a pronunciation chart, you can know that Paradise is how that name is pronounced.
There you go.
Jackie White runs into Ankrum, who gives up just a couple of yards. It'll be about 3rd and 10.
Here's what you need to know about Jackie White, and I was looking forward to watching this senior play today. 6'2", 220. That's a big running back.
Mm.
Yeah, he'll just stand you up and just keep on driving those legs.
I wonder, as this game goes on, you know, not only is it a big running back, but you pointed out the size of the offensive line and then the big guys they got behind the line. How long can James Island withstand this punishment? And so far, it's the Trojans delivering the punishing hits.
And Grant Morrow stands him up, and then Paradise comes in and finishes him off. I know you talked to Coach McCoy. Scotty did a little piece with him the other day, and you just get the feeling that he is the right guy for this job.
If you missed that, I'm sure it is on social media. If you follow Scott Eisberg on Twitter, I believe he did put it on there, his conversation with the coach.
Yep.
And really, he's just trying to educate young men. There was a lot about, you know, I want them to get out and vote, not telling them who to vote for, just be involved. He's a very religious man. In fact, he took this job, and one of the comments he said was, you can't keep saying no to God when they're presenting opportunities. Better kick here from McMillan.
Yeah, great quick kick.
And a great bounce as well. It skips right up to Dupree. And that enables him to scamper out to the 45.
I think James Island may have gotten away with a little push in the back. But, yeah, nice job. The rush was coming quick. They are a step away from blocking a punt. But, yeah, he was shared in Scotty's story that he had actually run, maybe pick up this push in the block. Yeah, right there. Mm-hmm. But he was talking to his mentor, and he told him that he was going to run for the State House in North Carolina out of Gastonia.
Nice opening drive for Sinigliero. Nice patient run for the freshman, Scott. But maybe it gets him back to the line of scrimmage.
So his mentor told him, you know, why don't you start small? Why don't you run for a local office first? And he's like, no, I'm running for the State House. And so he did. And he lost. And he went and talked to his mentor. And he said, I'm proud of you for trying, but maybe next time try for the local election first.
Got to walk before you run. Sinigliero delivers that one on target to Josh Harden down the sideline and pushed out of bounds for a couple extra yards. A first down for the Trojans.
I really like the way he throws his ball. I mean, it's a short delivery. Watch, he just cocks it right by his ear. Steps into it, throws it over the linebacker. Really well-placed ball. Josh Harden with the reception.
West Shore Homes presents that first down to the Cougars 35. Rotating backs here. Chris Hires is the first running back to hit him, 43. Teamed up there with LaMontre Green. It'll be second and 10.
Harden came in with just two catches for 12 yards, so that yardage there eclipses total yardage for the first two games.
James Island's been rotating their quarterbacks, and they've had some injuries at that position, but Jamar McCoy said they are all healthy and ready to go. He went with Sinigliero here ahead of his freshman Braxton Scott, who started and played three quarters last week. And well, Sinigliero has been very good in a drive and a half. Here's his first deep ball, and he overshoots him. One of Jaden Scott.
We saw him throw the short pass. Saw him throw the touch pass. Now he gives a little fake and throws a pretty good deep ball.
Almost looks like he threw it with more confidence in the deep ball. In the short ones, he's more aiming a little bit. Not to be critical, I think that was his first incompletion.
Yeah, what's up with you? Negative Nelly across the plexiglass.
With Dean Stevens and Darren Goldwater, we are in the studio back at the ABC News 4 and MyTV Charleston Studios. Thanks to our crew for once again producing quite a broadcast in these challenging times. Sinigliero isn't going anywhere. Josh McClendon is the first guy to register a sack here. That's back towards the 45.
Yeah, bad snap, broke that play down. He had a little crossing route he would think he was looking for. And by the time, the route had already finished off and McClendon was on him. Garvin Landon. Mr. Landon wasn't far behind.
Hugo Taylor handles the punting duties as well.
Here we go.
I can tell you, just based on what we've seen from his kicking leg, and that's a very good punt that he angles out of bounds. He could kick in college if he wants to at a certain level.
We've talked over our last, how many games have we had now, four?
I think so.
You know, one of the downsides of not being on the field, we talk about, you know, what a team looks like when they walk off a bus, right?
Mm-hmm.
You tell a lot about a team as soon as they walk off the bus. You don't have an opportunity to talk to the coaches, which we would do. But then we would also sit back and watch Hugo kick to see what his distance would be.
That's right.
But something tells me that kid can kick a football away.
Yeah. Here's Joran Simmons, first touch of the game, and he is ankle tackled. Maybe picks up a couple of yards. Amon Walker is the one who got a hand on him.
James Island with three players with an opportunity to take him down, one for a loss. He does a nice job of just getting back to the line of scrimmage.
There's a flag down, so we will check on the flag. Mistakes have been a big story here in the opening quarter.
Pretty good shot there of Jackie White. See how big he is.
5-yard penalty. James Island will give it right back. Drayton knows it.
Yep, you don't want to give him that gift. You've got him backed up to the goal line a little bit.
I believe that was the first penalty on the Trojans.
Collin County's got three.
And here's White now. That hole opens up. He bursts through it and gets to the third level and leading tackler Jaquan Wallace. A first down run for the Cougars.
Well, you've heard the expression about running downhill. This is what running downhill looks like. Look at him just barrel forward, picking up steam along the way. White, just a junior. Talk about somebody who may have an opportunity to play at the next level.
Nayron Holmes, a safety for the last couple of years, quarterback this year, gets about 6 yards. Ankrum starting to rack up the tackles here in the opening quarter. Kobe Peeler said, look, he was a great athlete. He could probably put a tennis racket in his hands, and he'd be good at that too. And they needed a quarterback. They said, this is going to be the guy to do it.
A couple of plus yardage plays back-to-back, which we've not seen from Colleton County at this point.
Here's Holmes looking for lots of plus yards, but he's out of bounds as Joran Simmons, and it'll be third down and four.
You talk about delivery and how they throw a football, totally different between the two quarterbacks. He'll take it all the way down from his back pocket. Almost looks like a starting pitcher just firing a fastball.
That's a dangerous, dangerous thing for a quarterback. If there's pressure around and you're going deep and you hang the ball by your knee.
Yeah.
High snap handled perfectly. White isn't going to get much, maybe a yard. The linebackers and the safeties for James Island have been excellent. Hunter Higgins is in there again. John Grant as well.
Yeah, when you're the last guy coming off the pile, off the dirt, off the grass, that's the guy, and it's Hunter Higgins. Fourth and short, and is there conversation here? I think he's let the clock run down.
He'll let him think about it. It's a pretty generous spot. Got about 2 yards and probably only picked up about a yard. What a quarter for the Trojans. They more than double their season point total in their first two games. And they're more than doubling up Colleton County. 14-0 your score, Keating Roofing. Friday Night Rivals driven by Cruz Chevrolet. Glad you're with us for Keating Roofing Friday Night Rivals. We're driven by Cruz Chevrolet. And it looks like the Cougars are going to go for it here. It's fourth down, a long yard, and a high snap for Holmes, but a lot of room around the edge. And a first down run for the 5'11", 160 senior that gets him to the 45.
Down 14-0. Kobe Peeler has seen enough. A nice call coming out of the quarter break. They've been stuffed in the middle. So get your athlete to the outside, and that's exactly where he went.
As their possessions have grown, so have the holes, except not on this one. Guess who? Hunter Higgins is the one who stuffs that hole. It's 1 yard on the ground for Jackie White.
Yeah, I like him going for it on fourth down there. Even though the field position was on James Island's side.
Your mantra is be physical and tough.
Yep.
And it's fourth down and a yard, and you've got a size advantage.
Yep.
You almost have to go for it. Stay true to your word.
Who's
maybe
on the
a yard
there
for Holmes. Looked like it was Chandler McCracken, 51, who was on the bottom. Yeah.
Coach McCoy's got to be so excited to see the effort by his defense. Giving up 28 in the first game against May River, 48 against Buford.
And now third down and 8 for this Cougars offense. There, Holmes again drops it down to his knee. He wants Simmons. An underthrown ball is played well by the receiver.
Yep.
And he's got it just outside the 30 for a Cougar first down.
Tough play by DJ Dickerson. He looks back again, and when he looks back is when there's separation from Simmons. Simmons does a great job of coming back to the ball. There you see the delivery from the bottom.
Another critical penalty against the Cougars that hurt them in the opening half. Illegal man downfield, replay the down. And back him up to the 42.
Yeah. Nice play by Josh Robinson of the Trojans, the other defensive back.
Got a timeout. It could be from James Island. It is. As soon as that shift in the offensive line occurred, or right behind him with those two H-backs.
Yeah, that was Bird and Bowman shifted to the left side. And the numbers didn't favor the James Island defense.
Second timeout used by the Trojans. And we crunch more numbers. Brought to you by Anderson Brothers Bank.
Yeah, don't play McCoy with me. This guy's had success, Jamar McCoy, when he was at Hunter Hess. He was 47-29 in 6 years, was 13-1 in 2018, won 40 games in 4 years. A similar situation, he said, at Hunter Hess. They were down. He was able to build them back up.
And that was his alma mater. I mean, he played there. He coached there. So imagine the emotions to leave there. But the similarities with James Island to his previous stop in Gastonia made him comfortable enough to do it. And look, 6 years, he had 47 total wins, and 40 of them came in the last 4 years. So give him a couple years, and let's see what this Trojan team looks like. Holmes stumbling down, gets to midfield, or just shy of it, and it'll be a long fourth down here.
Great job by the, he was number 65, is Kobe Ferguson. Moved his man off the edge to give him place to run, but not enough. Coach Peeler not comfortable with fourth and seven. Comfortable with fourth and one or two.
Keep an eye on this snap. And there it goes, over the head of Chandler McMillan. He falls on it, The Trojans are set up inside the 30.
It's a third bad snap that we've seen that has hurt Colleton County. And this is where you're the fourth-year coach of this program, and these are the mistakes you'd love to see eliminated, have to see eliminated, right?
Yeah. The first score of the game was a bad snap to the quarterback, and he eventually kicked it right to Hunter Higgins, who returned it for a score. Here's Jaden Scott now maneuvering through traffic. Good chunk of yards on the opening play on this possession for the Trojans.
Able to find some green space in front of the defensive backs and behind the linebackers. And Aiden has been on the mark, missed one long ball.
Give him 7 yards there to Scott. Cernigliero had 5 pass attempts before this game. He's looked very much in control here.
Yeah, no panic, right?
None. Third down and short into the Millermont College red zone. Take control of your future with skills to succeed at Millermont College.
I had not seen. He went to the sideline to get that play and then came back out. I don't know. I haven't noticed him do that throughout the game.
Needs about 2. Here's the freshman, Amontre Scott, who doesn't have the numbers, lowers his head into the Cougar defenders and maybe gets to the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, there was not, the speed was not on his side. Colleton County came quick and they came fast. James Island not able to seal off that corner. Dorian Gant, linebacker, 6'1", 180. See if we get our, Hugo's gonna come in and.
Yeah, show off that leg.
37-yarder from the far hash mark.
He certainly has the leg. 2 of his kickoffs into the end zone, another one just shy of it. But that's not a good snap. Dupree gets it down, and it is no good.
Off to the right. Yep. Tough snap. Nice job by Dupree.
14-0. Score remains the same from the backyard on this October evening. Our mass cam presented by DHEC, fight the spread. Colleton County prevented the spread of the score from widening right there after a bad snap put James Island in position, and a missed field goal leaves it as a 14-0 game. Mm. And you got a receiver who jumps off sides here. That's J. Todd Allen. I asked Kobe Peeler earlier today, because this isn't like college, right? You can't get game film to to study up for a game. So I said, describe your offense to me. I mean, I see the numbers. Obviously, you want to run the football. He said, we're kind of like Auburn in the Gene Chizik era with Cam Newton. That's the type of style we want to play. I said, okay. You're going to get 5 yards back for second down and 10.
They just want to run it. Throw it 12 times.
Yep. Jackie White hobbled off the field after the first play of the game, but since coming back in has shown absolutely no ill effects. And this is going to be Nayron Holmes, and Holmes isn't going anywhere. Holmes. Greg Harrison, hard-nosed kid. That's how he's described by Jamar McCoy.
Six total tackles on the year. Been picked up a couple already. Been really impressed with this James Island defense. Certainly prepared for the run today. One long ball by Colleton County called back because of a flag that hurt him.
They'll bluff the receiver screen with pressure at Holmes. It's deflected. Wow. Wallace was trying to time it out perfectly. He knocks it away instead.
That was a heck of a play. A little pump fake. Throws it up. Yeah, it does a nice job. And that tip drill almost came down to the arms of Amon Walker.
It looks so dangerous when Holmes goes to throw that deep ball.
Colleton County struggling to find rhythm.
That was a good snap, though. The punt goes straight up in the air. And will come to rest at the 44.
I never quite understood why there was always, you know, on a fire, fire, fire punt, right?
Yeah.
Which is usually the vocal command to, like, run to the sidelines, right?
Get away.
Get away. But you inevitably, there's always one guy, right? There's one guy.
Gamecocks know about that. That hurt them in the week one loss to Tennessee.
Yeah.
Sorry, that was a cheap
shot,
Gamecock fans.
It's too soon. It's too soon.
That was rough. That's my fault. I'm sorry. Good field position again for the Trojans. And that snap is handled well by Cernigliero, and McElvey powers his way for 7 yards.
I really like the way he runs the football. He just kind of puts his head down and goes, right? McElvey, watch it here. Nice job to give it up. And McElvey just puts his head down and goes. He gets it 4 or 5 times.
There he goes again. But he'll come up 2 yards short of the sticks. Remember the bus? Was it Bus Hamilton for James Island?
Yeah. Well, that was the year we were in the game. The quarterback got hurt.
Right.
And it was literally like snapping the ball to Jerome Bettis every play.
Every single time.
This is a big down for them. I know they'd love to go in with a 2-score lead, but could you imagine a 21-0 lead going into the half?
It would certainly open up a lot of eyes. Wider than that hole was for McElvey. A first down to the 17-yard line. Stopped by number 17, Jaheim Bellamy.
Yeah, another nice job. Hole opening up. It was a good job protecting the football.
First down brought to you by Limerick Heating and Air. The junior, Aiden Cernigliero.
Do they go back to the pass here?
No, nope. They're going to ride McElvey.
While they ride number 22, you also see the time just ticking off the clock. You know, I'm sure you take a, and I don't know how May River is. I don't even know how Buford is at a football team this year. Part of the new region alignment. But a strong showing here, what it would do for the birth of a young program under new leadership.
I can tell you what David Shelton told us on JB and Goldwater today. Noon to 2 every day.
I don't.
Never heard of it.
Oh,
right?
Wait, I was on that this week.
Yeah, you are. big-time featured guest. Cernigliaro is down. That's the second sack there for McClendon tonight. David Shelton said May River is certainly the class of the region. So I would assume he knows because he's been covering high school football down here for 50 years.
The two times that Aiden's gotten in trouble in the backfield is when he's tried to roll out when he hasn't been able to find a receiver. The two sacks tonight.
Got to get to the 16, maybe the 17-yard line on this long third down. Cernigliaro jogs his way up in the pocket into triple coverage, and he's fortunate that just falls incomplete looking for Scott.
Yeah, Antoine Griffith with a really nice play looking for Scott. Scott, a big receiver, probably about 6'2 or so. Looks right and comes back left.
Bet you Cernigliaro is a pretty good baseball player.
Flag on the play. Let's see what it is. You're going to say roughing the passer?
Or no? Offsetting. So they'll replay the down. Well, they should replay the down. Offsetting penalties, and you replay the down, but they've announced fourth down on the field.
And I think that was the three-finger wag I was getting off the sidelines.
Yes.
So,
James Island.
I think you're right.
I think I'm right.
You check with your wife, see what she thinks.
Yeah, well, she's going to agree with the officials. You can still see
we'll
four.
We'll call them third and 14 then.
That's what I'm going with. Another one deep down the middle into coverage.
We're
going to see if it was
fourth
down.
We're going to find out real fast if it's fourth down or not.
Guess it was.
Yeah, it was fourth down, fourth and 14. Now, if that's going to be your play call, you just went to it. Seemed like a very similar play. Where earlier he had that post across the middle when they were down at this end of the field for a completion. But I'm also not going to give this offense plus 20 yards here. Right? I'm going to let Hugo punt it down inside the 10 and let him go 90. They haven't been able to drive the ball consistently all game.
That's a good point. White almost dropped that handoff, and Hunter Higgins almost took that handoff.
Who?
Yes, him.
Now, it could also be just the confidence that McCoy has seen in his defense today.
We opened the day saying Colleton County's big. They want to play physically. It's James Island that probably heard that chatter, and they're the more physical team by a lot.
Keep an eye on Jackie White. He's set off at the bottom of your screen.
Holmes bobbles it, falls on it. Second time he's had trouble with the snap. The first time he tried to scoop it, and instead he kicked it to Hunter Higgins, and he returned it for a touchdown.
Yeah, all kinds of problems with the exchange from the center to the quarterback, center to the punter tonight.
Kobe Peeler takes his first time out of the opening half. Clemson grad is Kobe Peeler. He's a Clemson defensive back. And he played at Dorman College before that.
Dorman High School.
Yes. I consider it a college. It's huge.
Yeah.
I mean, you drive by it on the road, and it's hard to believe it's a high school.
Yeah.
But, yeah, it's Dorman High School. Clemson's got a big one tomorrow. That's on ABC News 4.
It feels like it, right? Yeah.
This is what we were talking about. The issues.
First touchdown for James Island, defensive touchdown.
Whoop.
And a nice job by McMillan just to fall on it.
Third down and 14. A pump fake for Holmes. This one hangs up there. It's tipped, and we got a flag. DJ Dickerson was battling there with, I believe, Jackie White. Nope, it was Jordan Simmons.
D- Dickerson does a nice job of turning around again. I think the official's going to say he got into Simmons' body before he did. And then he got a really played the ball well, tipping it away.
I tell you, watching it live, it'd be hard to signal out one of those guys.
Yeah, I think that's a let him play. Oh, we missed that. Oh, it's offsetting again.
Wonder if they lose downs again.
Yeah.
Now, if there's a false start, generally it would.
Wouldn't that kill the play?
Generally it would.
And I think that's what they're calling here. Didn't see that. Oh, you do have a little hand to the face. Since we're talking about wives, my wife's like, they're playing football, right? Why, if you hold a jersey, that's, you accidentally hit a guy in the face, you're playing football.
Yeah.
She's got a good point, doesn't she?
She does.
Third and 20, so they do count it as a dead ball, right?
Yes, they backed them up. And to the line of scrimmage goes Holmes.
Man.
James Island takes their final timeout here.
Smart timeout.
Love it. Gives them an opportunity to get a short field.
I think there's going to be some couple different conversations going on in the opposing locker rooms. You can almost, you know exactly what's going to be said in the James Island locker room, right?
Keep it up.
You know exactly what's going to be said in the Colleton County locker room.
Stop the mistakes and be tough. Be physical. Be what we said we want to be. I used to joke when I was the radio voice of the Citadel that I could do interviews with coaches asking the questions and answering the questions. Like, just
right.
Because you know what they're going to say.
Right. You know, you've done it long enough and you know.
Yes.
Right. You've watched enough games on TV. You've seen the interviews.
Yes.
You know, unless it's, you know, Greg Popovich or, you know, somebody like that, you have no idea what's going to come out of the mouth. But 95% of the time, you know exactly what's coming out of the mouth.
Right. And so you try and come up with different questions. And then after a while, you just say, that. Let's just have a conversation.
Yeah.
See what comes out of it.
An important snap here. Consider field position.
That one's on target. This one is the best punt of the night for McMillan. And that's how things have gone for Colleton County.
Exactly.
Best punt of the night, and it bounces backwards.
Yeah, that sums it up right there in a nutshell. Good punt. Backs it up about 7 yards.
James Island has been playing in Colleton County territory all night long, and they'll start at the 44 for this possession without a timeout, but with a minute 46 on the clock. And Mr. Aiden Cernigliero has been every bit the leader you'd want your quarterback to be.
See how they approach this with 1:45 left. Again, found space over the middle.
There it is again, but it's deflected at the line. Landon Garvin wanted the pick instead.
McClendon got his hands up, 6'2", 250. He's got pretty good reach. Yep. Got his right hand over. He's had a good game tonight. See if they try to get Jaden Scott involved in this play.
He was looking for Scott on that last toss. He gets rocked, and it'll be 3rd and 10.
A lot of jumping on the sidelines on the Colleton County side. And so what they've done, those two incomplete passes, they've left time on the clock for Colleton County. Yeah, he took a shot.
Yeah.
Pretty good one.
Yeah. And a flag now. I didn't see the call, but it looked like a personal foul.
No. It was against Daryl Green, number 31, hearing the Colleton County coaches screaming, that was a great play, Daryl Green. Let's see it again.
they gave a pass interference signal. That wouldn't make sense. But it's a 15-yard penalty. And Cernigliero takes off. First down and more as he jukes his way to the sideline. He's out of bounds close to the 10. The wheels for Cernigliero.
I didn't know if that was a juke or if it was a loose wheel. Lost a lug nut or something. But he got it done and picked up another 5 or 7 yards. Could have slid, right?
Not Cernigliero.
No. No.
No slide here.
No.
First and goal at the 8. About a minute 20 left on this second quarter clock.
Blitz in the middle.
And a deflection over the middle, knocked away by LaMontre Green.
Yeah, really well done. Chris Hires came up the middle. But another critical penalty. He had him 3rd and 10. The clock had stopped twice on the incomplete passes. 2 timeouts on the clock. And now you're just going to have to buckle down and hopefully they just pick up 3 instead of 7 here.
Yeah, they were one play away from getting the ball back where the Cougars.
Watch for McKelvey. Maybe delay a game.
All right.
Is that illegal formation? Remember the old cheat sheets? Do you remember the old cheat sheets?
I do.
With the officials on them, and they had the signs and what each sign meant.
I do. I don't want to be overly critical of these officials, but there have been some signs given that were not correct.
Okay. Okay.
Were not the intended signs.
I heard somebody say, watch out for the halfback pass here. It's the beauty of not having anybody in the stands.
Well, it's going to be a quarterback pass instead. And it's low. We wanted Armandre Scott incomplete.
Go back to what you said earlier. Looked more confident in the long ball, a little bit more hesitant on the short ball. Just instead of stepping in and just letting it rip, he kind of tried to put some touch on it.
He might have caught that.
I know what that sign means.
Yeah. Scott thought he had it.
That means, in my opinion, he did not catch it.
Yes.
Cernigliero coming off the sidelines, off that incomplete pass, getting this play from the sidelines.
It's a good thing that they don't go fast as an offense because he's doing a lot of running from sideline to the field. Screen's not there. Jaden Scott is. Cuts it to the middle and weaves in untouched.
Yeah. We were waiting for him to get involved in the game to watch the athleticism. We've heard a lot about him. And here you see it. Put the ball right on the money. A couple steps forward, and then there he goes. 14 catches, 114 yards coming in.
But that is first touchdown of the year. I don't think the clock moved on that play.
You don't?
No, pretty sure it didn't, but it's a touchdown. Look at Scott, he's in a box of defenders right here. No one touches him.
Yeah, I see you. You know, we watch every game we watch, we see kids who have the ability to go at the next level, right?
Yep.
You know, regardless of what the level is, doesn't matter. 1, 2, 3. But that's another level kind of move, right?
Yes.
That's just instinctively finding the end zone on your own.
Yeah, vision, right?
I mean, there were 3 guys that had a chance, maybe 4.
And they were all within.
Standing still.
Yeah, probably within a couple feet.
Good for him. Good for this James Island program.
They've had 8 wins over the last 4 years. under the direction of Ike Ulrich. Ike was a really good guy, just couldn't get it going.
And again, you go through the years of James Island football. I mean, there was success all over the place. You start slowly losing kids, and your numbers decrease, wins decrease. You go two thumbs up,
yep,
left and right. Says, let's go, boys.
That one's short and dropped. Oh, how he's dropped.
Josh Harden, wide receiver. Maybe you'd like to play linebacker today, young man.
Oh. There's your Will Lou Gray, never stop learning, stop of the game when we get to it. Mark that one down, Nick Case.
Oh, and he gets a belt with it. He gets the belt with it.
You should. He's not giving out turnover belts.
I think he's going up on the bleacher here. He's going up on the – he's standing up.
Looked like he might have had a little blood on his nose. That one's going to ring through for a long time.
Hunter Higgins, you got dirty pants, and that's a good sign. And if I'm Colleton County, I am not happy, right?
No. Yeah, he does have blood on his nose.
I think it's the bridge of the nose. That's even better.
He should totally be a linebacker.
You have been outplayed.
Magwood picks up maybe 7 there. Ankrum on the stop. Outplayed, out-physicaled.
Yep. And I think that's what's got to make Coach Peeler more upset than anything else.
Yeah.
Right? Look on the left side of your screen. You got the numbers. But James Island has just forced the issue at the line of scrimmage. And then the positive plays been offset by mental mistakes and penalties.
Tried to get tricky with it on the snap to Darryl Byrd. Clock will stop momentarily because of the first down, or it'll run out.
I would say that's the first half, best half of football we've seen from James Island in some time.
It certainly was. I was impressed. They were the more physical team. Cernigliero on the money for the most part. And I tell you what, defensively, they were fun to watch. Home of the Pro Bowler, Roddy White. Yes, 21-0, James Island leads it at the half. And we are going to do our best to talk with Jamar McCoy here. I'm sure he is pleased with the effort his guys have given forth here, trying to get the first win in his new program.
There's a sense of pride on that football field tonight.
And of all the things they did well, that hit from Josh Harden on special teams
summed it up, right?
It might be the best thing of the half. He'll take a little blood trickling down his nose for that hit, for that highlight.
Yeah, that's old. That's an old school cut,
it
right?
Is.
In the bridge of the nose.
Yes.
Right? Think back and that's to like when the, they, that's the when 80s. They started putting on the little horseshoe that kind of came down in the helmet.
Yeah. Okay.
Right.
That's what
you know
that
I'm talking
came
about.
From.
That
I do.
U.
Uh huh.
Yep.
Yep. Good linebackers. Sometimes they do have that.
Looks like we've got him down to the end zone.
We do, Coach McCoy. With luck. Can hear us or have the question relayed to him. First year coach at James Island, and after a first half year where you knew that Colleton County would be this physical, assess the job of your team matching that physicality.
Yes, I'm proud of our guys for being physical. All week we've been harping on our physicality and playing a tougher ball game up front, and I think we've done that in the trenches tonight.
Coach McCoy, what is the key to you to turn this program around?
What's the key to you? the key is to continue to do what we're doing, changing the culture, building confidence in our young men, and just being a more physical ball club. You know, watch film on them from last season. They were physical, but we want more physicality. We got a great bunch of kids, you know. We just want them to get better mentally and physically. So, you know, we're getting there. We're proud of the progress that we've made. You know, we've been hindered by the coronavirus like everybody else have. We're not making any excuses. But, you know, once we're able to get into the weight room in the offseason and really get strong, I believe this program is going to turn all the way around.
Thank you, sir.
Jamar McCoy.
I'm buying what he's selling, by the way.
Me too. You want physicality and confidence? Well, physicality will lead to some confidence after that half. 21-0. Roper St. Francis halftime report is next. Roper St. Francis Hospital halftime report is brought to you by Roper St. Francis Hospital, where experience matters. Experience in the classroom matters as well. That's why David Ehler Law Offices and Riders Law Group highlights scholar athletes from each participating school every week. Students selected have an opportunity to win a $5,000 scholarship at the end of the season. So how about our scholar athletes tonight? Daryl Green. Wow, look, GPAs are getting longer. It's not just 415. He's got 4156.
Round that up to 42, young man.
That's what I would do. And for James Island, Amelia Carson. See, 4-4, that'll work. She runs track. Congratulations to both. An opportunity to win a $5,000 scholarship at the end of the year, brought to you by David Ehler Law Offices and Riders Law Group. Speaking of David Ehler, he was with Scott Eisberg earlier.
Here with David Ehler from the Ehler Law Firm. Year four of the Scholar Athlete presented by you. $20,000, amazing, has already been given out, and that's not including basketball. How good does it make you feel year in, year out that we're getting to do this?
You know, it's great. It's great to be here again. It's been a great investment every year. As you know, we've met some awesome athletes from all walks of life, different sports, different school activities, as well as outside school activities, and they've all gone on, of course, to continue to succeed in their collegiate careers. So hoping for another another one this year.
How's life for you? Obviously, quarantine was an interesting time. How's your law firm doing, and how are times treating you guys?
You know, slowly but surely, we're getting back to normal. We got the office back open fully, and we're doing everything we can to, of course, follow the CDC guidelines, at the same time serving people.
Awesome. David Ayler from the Ayler Law Firm. We are talking scholar-athlete here on Friday Night Rivals.
Oh, good stuff there from David Ayler. Tell you what, just sent a video of my nephew laughing for the first time.
Yeah, how'd that go?
That's pretty cool, too. 21-0 at the half. James Island leads Colleton County. You're watching Keating Roofing Friday Night Rivals, driven by Cruise Chevrolet. Roper St. Francis Hospital Halftime Report brought to you by Roper St. Francis Hospital, where experience matters. Been a big fan of the new trophy this year. It's brought to you by All American Awards. For almost 30 years, All American Awards in Mount Pleasant has been your local trophy shop, providing both corporate and sports awards to meet your style and budget. Visit Steve and his crew at All American Awards when you recognize excellence. You can find them on the web. Awards Guy, that's plural, awardsguy.com. And the winner of tonight's game will take home that beautiful replica of the Lombardi Trophy. Love it, love it. Are we going to be in it? That's the big question.
I don't know. Oh, this is double coverage. Ooh,
that's pretty.
That's 2 feet down.
It's a nice field, too, in
Texas.
Yeah,
they don't mess around in San Antonio. No. Really all over the state.
Oof.
This guy's pretty good.
Yeah.
He's no Hunter Higgins, but...
It's also he can't be tackled.
What is this? There we go.
Oh, they're in the pink zone. I like it.
Oh. That was a perfect tackle. Face mask to the chest.
Oh, Hoover.
Alabama, one hand.
Nicely done. Yeah, nicely done.
That's pretty good.
Going to Asheville here.
Corner fade route.
Nice. Looks like Wake Forest playing Duke right there. Did you just throw the ball to the dude on the ground? Nice.
No, the dude on the ground came up with the play. Oh, we got a trick play. And he's going to throw it.
No.
He's
not.
He's going to run it. Look at the wall.
Look at that. His entire offensive line got to the end zone. Oh, we're going to Milwaukee.
We haven't been to Milwaukee ever.
Nah, we're going to get some cheat
sacks. Columbia.
Right. Oh.
Ooh. Oh, my goodness.
Smith.
basketball.
Dude, that was like separate hip from...
He caught the ball.
Wow.
That was nice. That might be the play of the year. We're coming up at the half. Roper St. Francis Hospital halftime report. It's 21-0 Trojans. Roper St. Francis Hospital halftime report brought to you by Roper St. Francis Hospital, where experience matters. Got some big games in the Lowcountry, and believe it or not, some of the biggest games in the Lowcountry aren't at the 5A level tonight. There's one in the Skeezer ranks that is a dandy, and then there's another one in what, 1A? That's what Oceanside and Hanahan are in.
Yeah, that's, I mean, think about this.
That's a Johnson Haygood Stadium.
That's a Johnson Haygood Stadium. That is Art Craig.
Uh-huh.
Timberland Oceanside last year, a couple of big games. Now at Hanahan, taking on Joe Call, new coach at Oceanside. West Ashley Somerville sitting at zeros. Wando Stratford, that's a big game for both those programs if you take a look at the conference standings.
And the loser's basically out of the playoffs.
Yep, but then Goose Creek handing it to Cane Bay.
How about this now?
What you got?
Hammond and C.J. Stokes visiting First Baptist could be the two best teams in Skeeza.
Yep.
And couple Hammond's
of great
got him
running
6-0
backs there, right?
Yep, yep. C.J. Stokes getting offers from all around the country right now. Berkeley beat Ashley Ridge yesterday. They were afraid of rain, so they moved it to yesterday.
It was a good play. It was we hadn't forecasted rain for this particular Friday. Maybe two Fridays ago, we were looking at a lot of rain.
But, you know, better safe than sorry, and they got the game in.
This is true.
You've heard us mention often, First Downs brought to you by Limerick Heating and Air. Let's find out more about Limerick Heating and Air.
We're here with David Miles, the owner of Limerick Plumbing, Heating, and Air. You do all sorts of things, and you're very involved in the community. Why is that?
Because the community helps us. Without the community, we wouldn't be here. And we feel a responsibility to give back to the community. And you know, it's also, it can be for selfish reasons. You know, we feel better as a group when we give to our community. You know, we walk with a little bit more pep in our step. We're a little bit more pride, have more pride and stick our chest out, so.
The Give Back Grant. Talk a little bit about that if you can.
Well, that's a grant that goes over all 12 months, and we pick a couple local charities each month that gets $500 each. For the Give Back Grant, and it is a way for us again to give back to the community. And some of our employees select some of them, and then the community selects some of them. So the employees have involvement and the community also has involvement.
Great to be teaming up with a great company, Limerick Plumbing, Heating and Air. That is their owner, David Miles.
21-0. Third quarter is around this timeout. See if the Trojans can maintain the physicality and their 3-touchdown lead on Keating Roofing Friday Night Rivals, driven by Cruise Chevrolet. Dominant first half for the Trojans, an opportunity to add to it to begin the second half as well. Alongside Dean Stevens and Darren Goldwater, Trojans are dancing, getting ready for this kickoff. If you missed the opening half, they scored first on a fumble recovery for a touchdown from Hunter Higgins. Offense moved the ball well, defense hitting hard. Dominated that first half, as the score would indicate. Here's Jaden Scott. His wall doesn't move, and neither does he when he hits it at the 20-yard line.
I think if we're going to learn anything in the next few minutes, I think we're going to find out what kind of conversation Kobe Peeler had with his team. Because they came out as flat as possibly could be.
Yes.
On both sides of the ball. I mean, they lost all three elements of the game, right? Offense, defense, special teams. The only thing missing for James Island right now is a defensive touchdown. Or they've got a defensive touchdown, right? Special teams. Oh, yeah.
Well, there you go. That's the physicality you're looking for out of Colleton County. Hustling up to fill that hole. I think it was Dorian Gantz.
Number 43.
Could have been Hires as well. Yeah, 25 was in there. 43 is Hires.
Yeah, he came flying in. Here he comes.
Boom.
I think, listen, they've got the talent and the skill to turn the tables here. But they've got to do it right now. Scott's in the slot, bottom of your screen.
Exactly where that ball was looking, and then it went over him to the actual intended target, but Dupree can't bring it in.
That ball was a, we like to call them rib crackers, right? A little high, stretched out.
Expose them.
Defensive back coming. All of a sudden, those arms shrink a little bit.
Yes. This will be a big stop for the Cougars.
Dorian Gant on Scott. See if he goes across the middle on him. There he is.
They only bring four. They don't get in there, but it's well defended on the back end by Jaheim Bellamy. And it'll be a three and out forced by this Cougars defense to begin the half.
I was waiting for a flag to come in. Didn't come. Take a closer look at it. So that was the first step of the conversation, is get the ball back. Defense, do your job. See if they can capitalize on special teams here.
Hugo Taylor with the boot, and they let it go. And he flips the fields to the 36-yard line. That's a 44-yard punt from Taylor.
I don't know if we've ever given a player of the game trophy to a kicker or a punter.
Both. That enhances his
P
possibility.
Slash K.
That's right.
See what happens here. A team that doesn't like to throw the ball a whole lot. But I think if there was a conversation to be had, it had to be with your guys up front here. Start owning the line of scrimmage.
Here's Jackie White not going down on that initial hit. How many? Four Trojans?
Yep.
Have to come in to help out?
Yep. And got a little push from the backside. Yep. Lawson Paradise came in, had a shot. It was a little late getting into the backfield.
Give him 6 yards there.
He's got a wall of blockers.
Yeah, full house going left, right? And it's a first down carry. That ball came out. They ruled it down. And this has been a very good start to the second half for a Cougars team led by Holmes, who 2 weeks ago in their only other game accounted for 280 total yards and four touchdowns.
Right.
It's your West Shore Homes first down. Find them online, West Shore Home.
This is a nice job riding on the backside of 74. That's Bowman, the halfback.
Nifty move from Nayron Holmes. Jukes it to the outside, and back-to-back first down runs for him. It's Jaden Scott bumping him out of bounds.
There you see why he picked up 121 yards on the ground. And listen, his passing stats would have been a lot better. Completed a 45-yard pass in the second quarter, but it's taken off the stat sheet by a penalty.
And speaking of which, a hold against the Cougars. It's 10 yards from the spot. The result of the play was a first down.
Yep, it was picked up 12, so it'll be.
It is still first down. They got that right.
Power on the right side.
Yeah, White never had a clean handle of that. He bobbled it as he went back to the middle. May have lost a shoe.
But that's also a situation where you had three or four guys leading the way, and he didn't really follow him. He kind of cut back. But trust me, if I got 74, 72, 50, and 73 leading the way to the buffet line,
I'm going to eat.
I'm eating a lot.
Unless they lead to the buffet line and don't let you get there. Holmes keeps this one, misdirection a little bit. Maybe back to the line of scrimmage.
It's John Grant. Tavon Drayton crashed the line. Grant or Drayton, a good-looking kid. There you see him.
McCracken sliding down the line, too. Penalties, mistakes, was a big part of that first half for Colleton County. Bit him on this drive, too. Should have been first and 10 from where that first down marker is now.
The 42.
James Island will give him five. Mm. Encroachment. Don't forget tomorrow night. Well, there's lots of really good games, but probably the game of the day is Clemson and Miami, and that's on ABC News 4.
7:30 kick. We'll find out how good Miami really is. We'll find out Clemson's first big test.
I picked Miami to win.
I picked them.
I'm chuckling because I'm not overly confident in that pick as White has a first down. But they've looked good. The ACC would benefit. And I don't think Clemson goes undefeated this year. And if I don't think that, then this is a game that they could lose. Or I'm just totally wrong.
I think the people looking to pick and criticize Clemson will look at that Virginia game and say, you know, they looked vulnerable in some areas.
After the West Shore Homes first down, they reverse it to J. Todd Allen, and James Island wasn't fooled at all. Drayton still hugging on to Allen.
Like that kid a lot. Look at his length. Lower body's thick. Hunter Higgins trying to get a paw in there. Watch Higgins come try to get that ball out of there. Looking for the strip.
And Drayton says, you're not going anywhere.
I was watching the 49ers play the other day thinking we were watching Javon Kinlaw play just 5 years ago on Friday Night Rivals.
5 years ago on Friday Night Rivals.
He graduated in 2015.
There's Holmes brought down by Scott.
Great play by Jaden Scott. I mean, this guy plays both sides of the ball really well, but a great open field tackle.
Yeah, I was thinking Clowney when you said Kinlaw.
No.
That's why I was all confused. But, yeah, Kinlaw, just out of South Carolina.
First time I saw him on the basketball court, I just thought the court was going to bend and break. He was the biggest guy I've ever seen.
Dre Magwood in the backfield now alongside Nayron Holmes. He's the lead blocker for him. Holmes backsteps and is drilled by Dickerson. And he may have given up the first down in the process.
He looked like if he would have planted a foot and cut it inside right about here. Instead of running away from Grant Morrow, he ran into Dickerson.
Yeah, he just needed one extra yard. He had it. And instead, he doesn't get the first down and takes that hit. Second time they've tried for it on fourth down. Similar spot, fourth and short.
Watch the linebackers crash. Here they come.
Here's Wright, gets to the edge, bouncing free, and now has the first down and blocking. It opens up down the sideline, and he scores. A touchdown from 31 yards out on fourth and one. Nobody could bring down this junior, Jackie White.
You saw a little bit of speed, but what you saw more than that was just the physical run of a 220-pound running back. Getting away from Lawson Paradise. And then Dickerson comes in, tries to push him out of bounds, but bounces off. And a much-needed drive and a much-needed score for a Colleton County team struggling the first two quarters of this game.
A three and out forced by the defense and a touchdown drive capped by Jackie White. First touchdown of the year. Two-score game, Keating Roofing, Friday Night Rivals driven by Cruz Chevrolet. crunch some numbers, why don't we? Brought to you by Anderson Brothers Bank. Not Cobra Kai.
No, it's Kobe Kai. We talked about him playing at Clemson. He was a DB there from 90 in 93. As a Greer assistant, they were 47 and 13. Now at Colleton County, trying to get them on the right track. 13, 24, and 1. 1-0 this year. And trying to lead his Cougars back on a comeback. Third and fourth quarter comeback.
Well, started the right way. Lots of good games around the Lowcountry tonight. Glad you are with us for one of them.
Uh-oh.
Here's Scott. Sideline opens up for Scott. He's already beaten the kicker here, and he's nearly down to the 30-yard line. Now we'll see what this Cougars defense really has.
I was going to say, and I was distracted by crunching the numbers.
Desmond Lewis is the one down, and a flag down as well.
If I was Colleton County right there, I'm kicking an onside kick.
It's funny you say that. I was thinking it. I was ready for it.
Were you?
Yes, that was in my head thinking be a good time.
I was going to say it because that's my job. But then I got I was distracted by Kobe Kai.
This kick's coming all the way back. The return is. Mm.
Looks like he took a
got a hold
a foot
here.
To the face, maybe.
I reference good games in the Lowcountry. We've got Stratford and Wando tied at 21 late in the third quarter. Oceanside has just taken a lead on Hanahan, 10-7. That's being played down at Johnson Haygood, the newly installed turf of Johnson Haygood.
Pretty cool for Joe Call, where he played his college ball.
That's true.
Got a nice letter today. When was the last time you got a handwritten letter?
Go. I have no idea.
I got a nice handwritten letter this week from
Joe Call.
Close. Mrs. McKissick.
That was my next guess.
She was.
Oh, Somerville's leading 3-0, speaking of.
Very complimentary of our work and loved watching the Somerville game that we did. She went, sat in her old seats. And
nice.
She used to sit with Coach McKissick. She said, just weather got too much, and I went home and watched the rest of it on TV.
I can understand that weather got too much.
That weather was too much before she got there, by the way.
It didn't kick off until 9:30. So Nigliero gets a couple there on the opening play of this drive that started at the 22-yard line.
Did a nice job on the fake. Linebacker takes the running back out. Every time I see Cernigliaro, I think of C and Sola.
Played for Dorchester, Penn State.
Cienciola, right?
Paul Cienciola. That one is complete to Dupree.
I feel like they could do that all game if they wanted to.
I agree.
They have been very successful just with that little three-step drop. And we'll pass over the middle.
DHEC reminds you, fight the spread. It is our mask cam. I do like the Trojans' masks. I noticed it when we were talking with Jamar McCoy at the half. And the uniforms. It's sharp. Some of the better uniforms in the Lowcountry. Unless you don't like the Florida Gators. Third and two. Take the play clock down. And it's stuffed. Chris Hires into the hole, stopping the freshman, Scott.
Colleton County defense stepping up, brought pressure up the middle, where McKelvey has found success in the first half, but not here. That was Scott taking it in. Hires going for the ankles. That's the first place you want to stop him, right?
James Island might be thinking about going for it here.
Well,
no, they're not. This is a different Colleton County team that came out for the second half.
I would imagine that Coach Peeler took him to church.
Yes. Nice hands back there for Hugo Taylor. And then the boot gets
the
roll. I don't know. Closer this game gets, maybe Taylor is the MVP. They're going to mark that at the 28-yard line for Colleton County.
It's Tuesday, November 3rd, so go vote! Sponsored by Jamie Harrison for Senate. The door to the American dream opens through education. Jamie Harrison is running to open those doors for all South Carolinians.
See what this offense has now. Second possession of the half. First one resulted in a touchdown run on fourth down from this man, Jackie White, who is carrying almost the entirety of the defense for 8 yards.
So when we talked in the first half, and really even pregame, and we talked about wanting to wear down this James Island team with the big numbers up front. And I'm not talking numbers on the jersey, by the way. I'm talking about the numbers on the scale. Maybe we start to see that a little bit.
And you wonder how much toll it can take if they played this style of play in the first half. If they're this physical for four quarters, as opposed to coming out of the locker room this way. Holmes, Hunter Higgins with the first hit. It's a first down. Helped out there by Chandler McCracken on the stop as the Cougars move James. First down brought to you by West Shore Holmes. When you watch football tomorrow, just think. Your old bathtub can be converted into a spacious walk-in shower by the end of the Miami-Clemson game. Just one day, that's all it takes. West Shore Holmes.
I mean, you talk about a true. This just hit me watching.
White went for that snap and picks up maybe three, falling over the pile.
When you take a look at Holmes and White, that is true thunder and lightning.
Mm-hmm.
Right, you get White in the open field, or Holmes in the open field. He can make a lot of guys miss. He's got the speed. And that guy right there is just bringing the thunder.
And he had some speed that he showed on the last drive, too, breaking away down the sideline. Only score for the Cougars. Looking at second down and about eight. Nothing there for Holmes. This may have been a designed run up the middle.
Yeah.
He plants his foot and he goes 0-60 immediately for another first down.
James Island's best friend right now has got to be the clock. Which means once they get this ball back, whatever happens on this drive, they've got to work some time off. Defense looking a little spent right now. Colleton County starting to own the trenches.
Watching that replay, there was no receiver out there. It was absolutely a designed run. Here's Magwood. Can't stretch it outside. That's Paradise up to make the stop behind the line of scrimmage. And he is in pain.
Hurt in his right leg or knee. The guy Desmond Lewis also on the outside.
It's a good example of how physical the defense has been for James Island tonight. Him coming up to make that hit.
Also a good break for that defense. Yeah, I think he just cramped.
Based on how the Colleton County trainer went out and started treating him, hopefully that is the case.
And let's give a round of applause to number 24, Lost in Paradise.
Yeah, he's been all over the field, seen him on special teams, on defense as well. It's been a warm week here in the Lowcountry. Warm night tonight on that field.
We're on TV.
Yes, you are, as is your voice.
Especially after, I thought it had cooled down. Like, I thought we were done with.
No, never done. Never done.
Never here. They fake the end around. Holmes has a man wide open. It's Simmons. It's two drives and two touchdowns in the third quarter for the Cougars. And they're back within a score.
Right, as I was talking about, you got to extend the clock, let them work on long drives. And boy, Holmes puts this one right on the money. Simmons does a nice job of getting behind the defenders. Has done it all night, really. A couple of big plays early on by DJ Dickerson.
And we've got a 7-point game, 8-point game. We'll see if that comes back to hurt the Cougars. See a replay of this one. No, we'll get a replay of the toss. That bluff of the end around had the defense biting. It opens up everything for Simmons on the back end. You want to talk about a big play receiver. That goes for a chunk of yards. Prior to this, he had 3 grabs for 116 yards in the only other game Colleton County had played.
Just thinking, I don't know, have we ever had an overtime game on Friday Night Rivals?
I believe so. Oh, yeah, that was close. Okay.
You said you believe so.
I do believe so. I think we have.
I believe you.
I'm not going to tell you which one it was. I just think we've been in that situation. James Island will have it at the 35 with that kick going out of bounds.
Considering Scott's last return, maybe not a bad move.
Now, James Island has not been able to move the ball this half. They had a very efficient offense in the first half, piece by piece, little by little, moving it down the field. Had a defensive touchdown as well. This half has been a different story. Colleton County hasn't given them anything. And I wonder if Cernigliero isn't getting a bit of a breather here. We've seen him come off the field.
Looks like we're going to re-kick.
Yeah, we are.
We're going to re-kick it. Yeah, I think aside from the fact it's a one-score game now, the importance of keeping your defense on the sideline for an extended period of time after they just spent most of the third quarter on the field is significant at this time.
Yep. I would expect James Island to run one play and take it to the fourth quarter. Returnable for Scott from his own 12. And Scott is wrapped as he crosses the 25, only about 14 yards on that return.
Yeah, that's a plus 10 advantage for Colleton County where that ball would have been.
Yep.
Again, I'm not quite sure what the penalty was.
It's a technically illegal procedure when you kick it out of bounds, so the team has the option,
there you go,
returning team, to take it at the 35 or have them back up and kick again. That's what they did, and it backfired.
Trojans' offense most effective when they ran it up the middle early in this game and then would hit some quick passes across the middle. But Colleton County has been stuffing the middle in the third quarter. See what they go with here.
On the ground, McElvey, a flag is out. So is the football, but it pops back to the quarterback, Cernigliero.
It was a quick flag too, right?
Oh, yeah, very.
Unless they called a hold. Mr. Garvin came in very quickly. I don't know the name of this gentleman, the ball guy.
No, he's there every year. He's
been,
awesome.
I swear to you, he's been there since 1990. I think that may have been the hold on Mr. Garvin. But he's been running that sidelines for 30 years. That's dedication.
Yeah. Text Eisberg, he'd know.
Yeah. Boom. He's the man. He's the man. What James Island did not want or need.
We're working together too much. You're taking words out of my mouth. First and 20, not there. Hires is there. It's a pretty good indication on these last two plays of how this third quarter went. Physicality for the Cougars, different team. They've got a want to in this second half that was not present in the first.
Yeah, the clock's at 30 seconds now, so they do not have to run a play before they can get off the field and flip the field here. That's exactly what's going to happen.
Yep. Going to head off the field already. Third quarter owned by the Cougars of Colleton County. They've erased a 21-point deficit. They're within eight as we head to the final quarter of play on our Keating Roofing Friday Night Rivals, driven by Cruise Chevrolet. You're watching the first Keating Roofing Friday Night Rivals driven by Cruise Chevrolet game this year that is looking like it's heading down to the wire. 21-13, James Island's been going the wrong way this half. And it's third down and long as we start the fourth. Dupree, the intended target there for Sinigliero.
Had him open.
Yes, he did.
Had him open. Colleton County obviously made the right adjustments at the half. Now we're going to be able to see if James Island can make adjustments from the third to the fourth.
Coach McCoy told us at the half, he wants physicality, he wants confidence. Part of confidence is learning how to win. When you have a lead, another team comes back, makes it tough. How do you respond? It's part of learning how to win. The line holds up. Cernigliero takes a shot for Scott. And I thought he put it in a decent spot.
He did. He did. It was a good ball. Just missed him a little bit to the left. I thought they would have maybe run the ball, start working on that clock a little bit. Because what it's going to come down to here is how many possessions are you going to limit Colleton County in the first quarter? Because they weren't stopped in the third. And if you're the James Island defensive coordinator, you've got to avoid the big plays.
That one didn't sound good off the foot of Hugo Taylor. And it's out of bounds just across midfield. I'm not sure if James Island has a first down in this half. If they do, they have one.
And first series was three and out. That series three and out.
Uh-huh. And now this defense is back out there protecting an 8-point lead. Cougars trying to go to 2-0 and withstand the first half of not playing up to their potential and putting mistakes on top of that. There's Jackie White. Speed and shiftiness, right? A couple yards there.
Yes.
Jaquan Wallace with the stop.
James Allen had a defender in the backfield, but you cannot arm tackle number five. Not even close. See if they start to maybe pull the linebackers up closer to the line, start filling the gaps. Beat them to the contact. Yep, here they come.
Where? Oh. Filled very, very well. That's Drayton.
It's my guy.
Yes, it is.
I don't know if he was getting up gingerly or if that was his. Yeah, he just. Yeah, and a holding call could have been called there as well. But he just beat his man to the gap and then got into the backfield.
He's tired. But Colleton County will give him a breather.
He should be tired. He's played hard. All that defensive side of the ball played very well. Colleton County found something in the third quarter they were able to exploit.
Let's look at our Will Lou Gray. Never stop learning. Stop of the game. And so far, it's the stop of the year. Incoming.
And you get a little blood on the face as well. Drips down the nose. And you get a little taste of the blood. And then you get the belt. I wonder if you get to take the belt home.
Well, what if someone else has a big hit and he gets the belt?
I would say it's up to him whether he gives it up.
They can box for it.
Big play here, third and 10 for both sides of the ball. That's Simmons on the top. Gonna throw it back.
Holmes had his man. The separation at the end there for Simmons.
I like the play call a lot. Get your athlete outside of the pocket. First time he's played quarterback. When you saw Simmons' speed coming across the field. And an absolute must stop for that defense. I just love the way he just rears back and just wings it, baby.
Everything he's got, and he just missed Simmons. So the Cougars elect to take a shot there on third and 13, and McMillan fumbles it. The Trojans have it at the 40. Another mistake in the kicking game gives the ball back to the Trojans when Colleton County had everything going for it.
Yeah.
And
Tykel Maxwell, the sophomore, coming up with a huge turnover. Right through the hands of the punter. Now we'll see how James Island uses this clock. Colleton County used a timeout in their last offensive possession.
Quick change, 40-yard line. They're not going to take a shot. Instead, they keep it on the ground, and into the arms of Josh McClendon goes McElvey.
Yep, just sticks his nose in the middle of the pile. Looks like he picked up three or four. Call it two instead.
And now James Island can use some clock.
Well, you take a look. It was 10:25 when they got the ball. There's 20 seconds on the clock right now. We'll see if they work this all the way down.
Oh, they are.
Now down to 10 seconds. Second. That's just some great coaching by McCoy. Love that.
Like you said at the half, I'm buying what he's selling. Second down and eight. There's McElvey. Gets to the second level. Chris Hires has had a busy day.
And there's the cramp.
Yes, sir.
That's the universal sign of my calf is hurting a lot.
My calf's the size of my head.
He's telling his teammate, back up, back up.
But he got the first down. What was necessary.
Yep. Love the way he runs the football. Doesn't look like to be the biggest running back out there, right? Certainly not 220. Now Colleton County's defense gets a chance to kind of collect themselves as a unit.
Let's crunch some numbers for the final time tonight. Anderson Brothers Bank brings you South Carolina Media Poll. Fort Dorchester is putting it on stall tonight.
Yep. Goose Creek played, as we said, or that was Berkeley yesterday.
That was Berkeley. Goose Creek is leading big against Cane Bay right now.
I did notice Oceanside at 9, but Hanahan received some votes. And it's not going to take Art Craig long there. Just not.
Well, they've already got 2 wins, and they had 1 last year. Oceanside leads at 10-7 in the fourth against Hanahan right now. Fort Dorchester leading stall 70 to nothing.
20 seconds on the clock here. Let's see what they do. They're going to tell him to back up. Looks like he'll get back under center. You see him looking at the clock. Gets back under with about 7 seconds.
The freshman, Amontre Scott, is in the game in place of McElvey. He's the one with the ball, protecting it with 2 hands. Anton Griffin, the safety, makes the stop.
I had to look again. You said freshman. I had to look at the roster. 9 next to his number. I mean, he just put his head down and went through the hole.
The quarterback who started the last game for James Island and played 3 quarters is also a freshman. Part of changing the culture. McCoy needs guys who are going to buy in. Second down and 1. 10 seconds now on the play clock for Aiden Cernigliero. Hoping to guide the Trojans to a victory, which would be the first of the McCoy era. There's a flag behind that play. And a little jawing from Lamontre Green.
Yeah, nice tackle by Green. I was just thinking that offense has been pretty clean. See how this flag goes. Probably on the corner. They were trying to spring him. James Island's offense, that offensive line, not the biggest group out there, but the most experienced. I didn't see anything there.
Didn't
did you?
See it there. No, I didn't see it there.
By the way, that's my man Dravon Drayton in the backfield blocking. Getting a little clarification on where this play is going to go. But you've got an all-senior offensive line obviously work well together. And they've controlled this game for the majority of it.
You can see the play clock there, back of the screen.
Looked like Colleton County just jumped offside. You saw a hard count by Cernigliero.
So that gets 5 back of the 10 they lost with the hold. This would be a good win.
Boy,
for the first quarter, McCoy.
Coach in his quarterback's ear. Love that.
I mean, imagine all the teachable things if they do pull this out. How well they played in the first half. The struggles in the third quarter. Overcoming those to win the game. I mean, it's like a statement for your first win with a new program. They got to get there first, though.
Drayton with a nice block.
Hires with the stop.
And he blocks it back. Picked up a block at the line and then went and found somebody else. Again, I don't know how much experience he's had offensively. But defensively, he's played great tonight.
And they're moving the pile offensively, this line with Drayton behind him. And that's something they couldn't do in the third quarter. They couldn't move the chains because they couldn't move the line of scrimmage.
I talked about limiting the offensive opportunities for Colleton County. They've got the ball for 3 minutes now after that turnover. You're going to have to get a timeout here. We had a little shoe malfunction by the freshman.
He wasn't even at the line of scrimmage.
But what they did is they allowed the play clock to go to one, called the timeout, let the game clock move to 7:18.
How about our Cruise Chevrolet drive of the game? Going to drive you to Rivers Avenue, where you've got a friend in the car business. The drive of the game.
That's a quick one, baby.
It sure is. It's a kickball to Hunter Higgins. That was your first score of the game. But it shows you there have been issues in the snap all game long. The latest turnover wasn't because of the snap. It was a perfect snap. It went right to the head of the punter, McMillan. But it went through his hands and hit his head. So here was the first bad snap. It leads directly to this score. McMillan's had a tough time of it. He's had to pick one up off the turf and run back to get one. Third down. Here's third down and two.
Oh,
a little bit of a counter here, and it frees up Scott. A race to the pylon and a score for the freshman. What a call from Jamar McCoy. These Trojans are back up 14.
Brilliant. Look at him laughing. Man, you know, we don't smile and laugh during the pandemic. But you do tonight when you're a brand new coach. Losing two games in a row out of the chute, dominated in both. Now you come home on TV, Friday Night Rivals, give me a dance. He gets the belt. He gets the belt.
What a call. What a call. We haven't seen that at all from James Island today. Calls the timeout. Runs what you would imagine they've been working on. And it becomes a 28-13 lead, capitalizing on the fumble. And they're 7 minutes away from the first win in the Jamar McCoy era. You're watching Keating Roofing Friday Night Rivals, and we're driven by Cruise Chevrolet. James Island with a bit of separation, big score, capitalizing on the turnover. And here we are in your Keating Roofing Friday Night Rivals, driven by Cruise Chevrolet, alongside everyone's MVP, Dean Stevens.
So kind.
I'm Darren Goldwater. What a performance for James Island tonight. Colleton County's put together two nice scoring drives in the second. Hey, throwing it back into the end zone. Now we got problems. Just do get it back out. Yikes.
This whole game, you're waiting for somebody for Colleton County to take control, you know? Misjudged the ball, picks. And I think was trying to throw it back to him.
He was. Penseel, I guess, decided he shouldn't have cut in front of Simmons in the first place.
I don't know. But we've seen they've got the ability to score quick.
They've been mostly extended drives. Right there, he is stood up at the goal line by McCracken.
The Blue Storm.
The Blue Storm of Trojans. If that doesn't scare you, I don't know what will. No urgency here. Down by 15 with 6 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. But there have been turnover issues and mistakes, so you got to be sure if you're Colleton County that that's not happening here. Underthrown ball, well played by Simmons again, who had Dickerson turned around. It's almost like a back shoulder throw, except it's just an underthrown deep ball.
I think Dickerson wanted an offensive interference call. I think that's what he was telling his teammate. Let's see if we see it here. No. I think it was clean. Simmons, good little receiver.
By the numbers, best one they've got. He's the one they take shots to the most often. He's got it here, gets by Dickerson, but stepped out of bounds.
Boy, made a guy miss. Just ran out of real estate on the sidelines.
Big break for the Trojans. He was probably gone.
Yep. And boy, you... You'd like to be able to see this Colleton County offense go a bit quicker. I don't know how many pass plays they've got in their playbook.
Rear back and chuck it or get it to the edge.
Oof.
Big hit up high. White was already going down low in the grab of McCracken, and he'll be a little slow to get up.
I think it was the first play of the game he hobbled off the
field.
It was
the very first play, but then he came back on and has been effective. He's got a 30-yard touchdown run that came on a fourth and one.
I think this is a first, my friend.
It is. This
is exciting.
This is a first. Our Keating Roofing player of the game. Let's put an S on that. Players. The offensive line for the Trojans.
I got this. Nolan Bullard, Carter Kreitz, Daniel Vohl, Will Sheely, Omar Sanders. Handling the line of scrimmage, protected the quarterback, and around the counterplay to perfection. I can't wait for the celebration of the end, if it ends up that way.
5:51 to go.
They need a quick score here.
From the 45 with a fresh set of downs, clock moving. And Holmes saying one quick word to Magwood before he launches another one. And this is dropped.
I don't know if Dickerson got his hand in there.
If you're these defensive backs now, it's a challenge. How do you play the expectation of knowing these balls are going to be underthrown?
He did. He knocked it out of. Yeah, I don't know. You know, because you don't want them to get behind you.
Yeah.
But it's. I mean, they're jump balls.
Every one of them.
Makes it pretty darn exciting, doesn't it?
Every ball. It could be anyone's ball. Line went right, play goes left. Holmes slips through one, and he is taken down by the second man to get to him, Lawson Paradise.
Higgins slows him down. Paradise cleans up the mess. And the clock keeps ticking. Again, last offensive possession, they called a timeout. So they've only got two left.
They did that before a third down play. And have they taken another one here?
feels like it. Offensive coordinator in the huddle for Colleton County.
Yeah, there's a timeout on the field. I would assume, this is a cardinal sin for a broadcaster, I'll do it anyway, that Colleton County took the timeout. I don't know that for a fact.
No reason for James Island to, unless right. they had the, didn't have the, they were missing a guy on the field.
Fight the spread, DHEC reminds you, presents our mask cam tonight.
Families that mask together, stay together.
Out of the timeout, a whistle.
Not in a hurry.
Illegal substitution.
Out of a timeout. It's as if he looks to turn on his microphone, but yet we hear nothing from his mouth.
Yes, that is exactly what is happening.
So you think maybe they had too many guys on the field and then tried to get one off late? Coming out of a timeout?
I probably. Holmes, dangerous ball. Paradise was the closest one to it, and he's wearing blue.
I'd like to see Holmes get out of the pocket, and then I'd like to see him take off.
We haven't seen that.
He's got the ability to go 50 yards.
Oh.
Quickly.
Absolutely he does. Got another timeout.
I think this is going to be James Island's timeout. I think this is Colleton County's timeout, which makes me think maybe the last was James Island. I mean, Colleton County going to use their two timeouts there. But again, fourth and five with 5 minutes left.
Yeah,
you
better, this is a big play.
You have to dial up the right play here.
This feels like the game right here. With only one timeout left, a defense that had been playing great but got pushed around a bit on the last drive, that, to the defense's credit, started deep in their own end anyway.
You look at the stats from last week and making up our boards, and you look at Simmons' stats. He had three catches last week for 116 yards, right? And now you understand how and why.
Yes.
And that's about 37 yards or so per pop.
Got some decent tunes at the backyard tonight. Got to get to the 45 of the Trojans.
Keep an eye on Jaden Scott. Looks like he's keeping an eye on Simmons.
Got nine guys close to the line of scrimmage. Simmons on the reverse. That is not going to get there. He may have had designs of throwing that.
Looked like it for a second, but he's your playmaker on fourth and five. Great job by the defense, forcing the pressure, not allowing him to get, you know, to cut a corner. That's Dickerson right there. He's had a great game as well. Allowed Simmons to get behind him for the long touchdown. That was about it.
We've already named the offensive line of the Trojans as our players of the game, and they can seal the win with a couple more good plays here. Oh, we're moving the ball.
I don't know if Colleton County's got a timeout left.
The scoreboard in the stadium says one. So what we are showing appears to be correct. There you go.
Well, then I don't know who that one timeout was, a mystery.
Yes, it was.
New quarterback in.
It is. Just so that they can go wildcat a little bit. This is Marion Champagne. Marion's a senior.
Good for him to be out on the field if they keep him out there for the last drive. Senior's gone through some rough times. Not going to pick up a great win here. against what could be, I think, a really good football team. 28-7 against Bluffton. They've got to turn around and play May River.
Strange to see a team play as well as James Island has played under the direction of a quarterback. And on a drive trying to put it away, he's out.
You put in the running guy.
Yes.
But you've got McKelvey back there, too.
That's a delay of game.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's a numbers game at that point. When you're running the Wildcat, that's an extra guy you got blocking, and then you've got a big quarterback you've brought in. He's certainly more equipped to run this than Cernigliero is.
But you also run into the problem, too, of bringing a guy who has not been in the entire game and loses sight of the game clock.
Yes.
Or the play clock, should I say. McKelvey. See the strength of that lower body all night tonight.
Clock approaching 4 minutes. And a 28-13 game. A late pitch out to McKelvey. And a good pitch, although dangerous.
Yeah.
And to the 45 he goes.
Yeah, you kind of took a deep breath there,
yes,
didn't you?
Yes, you did.
There's only a couple things can happen. Most of them are bad. Woo. Nice job. Nice hands, right?
Looks like a pretty well-coached team the first year under new coach.
Third and eight here. He's keeping an eye on the clock.
Yeah.
You get it rolling.
It.
Yep.
Nice job by our crew to get the play clock in there for you. Hole opens up. A first down for McKelvey. Spinning his way close to the 20-yard line.
Number 22,
and the Trojans can taste this.
First down
brought to you by Limerick Heating and Air.
Nice block on the inside. That was Will Sheely. You saw him come across. Seal the hole. Gave McKelvey a chance to pick up another 15 yards.
And let this clock roll.
And I'm not a big Gatorade bath kind of guy, but McCoy deserves one tonight.
He does. Doesn't give it to the freshman back, Scott. It was a late pull there for Champagne. And probably the right read.
Yep, smart play. Because at this second down play can be probably called with about 2:05 left on the clock.
Yes. Almost exactly on that number.
So one more first down, and I think they're able to walk away with a victory. Two on the clock.
Keeps it again.
Sure he does.
Champagne jukes it right. Angles again to the sideline as Cougars collide with each other. He's down to the three.
Hey, Marion Moore, you saw it. And the wide receiver. Nice downfield block. The excitement. Knowing they picked up their first win. Their first coach. Watching right here. Yes!
That's going to be fun to watch in the film room.
You know, and it's just when you put in the work, right? And I'm not sure how long it takes for a first-year coach to get buy-in from a team, right? I don't know how long that takes.
No.
But I think for James Island, it's taken 2 weeks.
You know for sure that this helps a lot. And it's not the win that will be the buy-in. You could see that. The buy-in was the...
Look at number 8, Tyquell Maxwell on the backfield as well. Just a sophomore.
Yeah, the buy-in helped create this win.
Uh-oh.
Yes.
Hold on.
That's Landon Garvin.
Mr. Garvin has earned our respect tonight.
So next ball will be snapped at about 40 seconds. They can take a knee.
Yeah, I don't...
And get out of here.
Yep. I think they want seven more. I think they want to get their senior
into the end
backup
zone.
Quarterback into the end zone.
Play clock at 10 right now. I told you they'd snap it right around 40. And instead they give it to McKelvey. No. He is held up at the 2. And they don't have to snap it again. First-year head coach Jamar McCoy, who left his alma mater of Hunter Huss High School in Gastonia, North Carolina, to come down to James Island.
And he got
his bath. He got that bath, and he gets the belts. And a new era of James Island Trojan football has been born tonight in the backyard.
That's pretty awesome. We've seen a lot of cool things on Friday Night Rivals. That's got to be... That's right up there,
it's
man.
It's up there. It is.
That's wild, man.
It's a great scene. There's no words I can put on top of that to make it better. It's just smiling as you watch it. Hopefully we'll hear from Coach when we get you back here. Celebration, tag the offensive line as the players of the game. First win in the Jamar McCoy era for James Island. James Island never trailed. They led it 7-0 in the first series of the game, recovering a fumble for a touchdown. Led 21-0, then faced a bit of adversity. Colleton County dominates the third quarter, gets within 8. But the Trojans tack on a score and win it 28-13, the first win in the Jamar McCoy era of James Island Trojan football. Give them that trophy. They deserve it. There's the offensive line. They got the belt. They got the Lombardi.
Great job.
And we got Coach McCoy. First of all, Coach, congratulations. Tell us how far the offensive line. Tell us how far this offensive line has come to get you this win.
Yes, sir.
Give it a McCracken. Give it a McCracken.
They've come a long way. Come a long way through injury. Through the sick bug, they've come a long way. You know, we dealt with an offensive lineman that had a stomach bug earlier this week, and just trying to work together and put a line together for this week has been tough, but they came ready to play tonight.
Coach, when was the last time you teared up over a win?
Coach, when was the last time you teared up over a win?
The last time was when we went 13-0 down at Hunter Huss. But, you know, tonight felt good, felt really good to get these guys to where we want them. So, you know, we're sitting at 1-2. We're not quite where we want to be yet, but we see progress, and that's the thing about football. It's a game of inches. You always want to move forward, so our guys are moving forward. To earlier tonight, we talked about wanting to be successful more than you want to breathe. So tonight, they was successful. You know, they wanted success more than they wanted to breathe, and it showed tonight with the fourth and goal mentality. Every down is fourth and goal. They played hard, they played physical, and that's how we coached them all week long. And we have the victory, so we're really proud of our guys.
All right, guys, congratulate them on the win. Congratulations, Coach. Celebrate it up with the guys. First win of the Jamar McCoy era.
I think I want to go run through a wall. You want to go with me?
Like, did you not just become a James Island fan tonight? Hard not to. Hard not to like Jamar McCoy. Good luck to the Trojans moving forward. They pick up their first victory of the season, 28-13. Thanks to all our sponsors for making FNR possible. Next week, we are back at it yet again. Same time, same place for Keating Roofing Friday Night Rivals, driven by Cruise Chevrolet. Stahl and Cane Bay next week. Later tonight, tune into ABC News 4 at 11 for Friday Night Rivals. Complete rundown of scores from around the Lowcountry. We'll see you next week. For my partner, Dean Stevens, our entire award-winning crew, and the offensive line of the Trojans.
First time ever.
I'm Darren Goldwater. Congratulations, young men.